I haven't been that excited about software development in a long, long time. Actually, when I think about it, last time I had that kind of excitement was when we achieved the very first TMS web core web applications that we built from the Delphi IDE, or when we achieved that we built FNC controls that we could use both in a VCL application, a FireMonkey application, and a web core application. And now it's finally there, that moment of excitement again. And that's why I want to share here with you in this sneak peek the AI evolution, or I would rather call it revolution, for and with Delphi. We're going to discuss, I'm going to give you a sneak peek of how you can give AI access to data from your own Delphi applications, how you can let AI perform actions within your Delphi applications, and also finally I'm going to give you a glimpse of how you can give AI access to the Delphi IDE itself. I've prepared a couple of samples for this sneak peek, so join me in the Delphi 12.3 IDE where we will go through it. So I want to share with you what's been brewing in the TMS labs in connection with AI. And here we have our Delphi 12.3 IDE with a VCL application, that contains our FNC maps component that you can see here on the form. First of all, I'm going to show you the result, the demo, and then we are going to have a look what's behind this demo. So here we have the VCL application running, showing a map. This is actually Leaflet Maps, free mapping service that we expose through FNC Maps. And what I have here is the Claude AI desktop from Entrophic. And I'm going to ask something from the Claude AI. What I'm going to ask is, please show me on the map the UNESCO World Heritage places in France. So that is what I'm requesting from the AI. So the AI starts and it asks us access to our application. And as you can see, while Claude is doing its work, you can see the UNESCO places for France being added with a marker on our app in created with Delphi, created with the FNC Maps component, and it's processing a little bit. You can see markers being added. Let's wait for it to be finished. You can also already see a couple of details here in the logging in our application. It continues to add a few more places, and then we are going to have a look at the result. So here you can see that Claude informs us that it added the major UNESCO World Heritage sites in France on our map. And if we go and have a look in detail, you can also see here some title so that we can see what place has actually been added on our FNC maps here through the Claude interface. And so this is, for example, also Mont-Saint-Michel that it added in this map. And this is, if I would give another command asking for other markers to be added to our map based on something completely different, then of course it would just do what I'm asking here. So the question is now, how did we achieve that? Well, to explain that, we need to have a look at the MCP tool that we installed in Claude. And if we have a look at the source code of this tool, you can see here that we created in Delphi code an MCP server. And I have to focus first on our map. So here we actually added a set of tools that gives AI access to our map, and we give the tool a name and a description. The description is the most important part, because the AI will determine what to do from that description. So add a marker to on the map is sufficiently clear for Claude AI to perform the actual adding of a marker on the map. You can also see here that we specify that adding a marker on the map involves three parameters. Parameters being the latitude, the longitude, and the title of the place that goes with this marker. And the other tool that we installed specifically for this mapping example is clear markers. So when AI starts, it will also be normally smart enough to first clear all the existing markers on the map. And so with these two tools installed, that is sufficient to enable Claude to interact with our Delphi application and perform what it wants to do with adding markers. And in the same concept, we can actually do something with an FNC chart, for example. So here in the same MCP server created with Delphi, we have a couple of more tools that we have added, and that is a tool to add a line series to a chart, a bar series, a byte series to clear the series, and finally also to add a point on the map. And also here, of course, very important is the description that goes with it. It is, as I explained, the description that will determine if the AI knows what to do with your request. And so if I now would start my chart application, so here is a very simple FNC chart dropped on a VCL application. So let's run this application, and this will listen to the MCP server installed with Claude. I'm also using Claude here, but meanwhile there are other clients that you can use for your MCP server, like for example cursor.ai is an IDE that can work with this same MCP server. Visual Studio Code got recently also support for it, and I expect many more tools to be equipped with support for that. So now I have my VCL application with the FNC chart running, and so let's give Claude another command to fill a chart here in my VCL application. And what I'm going to ask from Claude is, for example, create a pie series in my chart and fill this series with distribution of the people's most favorite fruits. So let's see what favorite fruits of people are. So it gets in action. It asks for permission to access this MCP server, this Delphi MCP server. And it already created a series, as you can see here. And now it is adding the data points. So let's fill our pie chart for us. And so what it says now is apple appears to be the most popular fruit for people. I didn't know that. 32% of people prefer apples. Second one is bananas, strawberries on the third position, and then oranges, mango, and pineapple. And this is how it created this particular pie chart here for us. We could do exactly the same, asking for some other data and bring up the appropriate chart for it in our VCL application with the FNC chart component. And last but not least, I also want to show you how you can actually integrate this into your or let it work together with your Delphi IDE. So what we have created here is a package that we can install in the Delphi IDE. The plugin is loaded at this moment, so it's loaded and is supposed to be running, and what I'm going to ask now from the Claude AI is, for example, show me a list of projects and files in the Delphi IDE. And let's see what it comes up with. It wants, again, permission to access my MCP server. And as you can see, it has retrieved this information. So this project here and all the files to the other project, it has retrieved all this information. I can do something more, actually. That's also a command that we enabled. Add a file to the active project in our Delphi IDE. So let's see what it does. It. I allow this command to happen, and actually it already added that new source file. This is the active project and the source file that I hard-coded in this case, that I asked to be added is here the gs.pass file from WebCore. Of course, it's meaningless in this example, but it shows you how you can actually create commands that are executed by the AI. And of course, these are at this moment simple commands, but if your prompt is more elaborate, evidently then it will perform all the actions needed to actually achieve what your prompt is requesting. And so, to also give you a view from the other side, from the AI, you can see here the installed MCP tool. So that is the MCP test that we created here. And you can see that these are all the commands that were registered, the tools that were registered with our Delphi MCP server application. And so you can see here the commands, tools to add bars, line charts, markers on the map, pie chart, and also here to list project files in the Delphi IDE project manager. And also here at source is the tool to add a specific source file in the active project in the Delphi IDE. And with that, I think you can create whatever you want. It all depends on what tools you provide to the AI, and just let the AI work with it. So I think these are extremely exciting new possibilities that open up for us Delphi developers, for what we can do for our existing Delphi applications, but also what we can do with our Delphi IDE from AI tools, like, for example, Claude that I showed you in this demo. But you can, and you will in the future, be able to also do this with other AI engines. I believe that the possibilities of this technology are only limited by our imagination, and let's explore together the horizon of what kind of capabilities this all opens up for us. We want you to be involved in this evolution, or rather revolution, with AI, so be in touch if you want to have access to early developments and play with it for yourself. We offer you to get that as an all access user, so be in touch. If you want to participate in further research, testing of IDs, exploring new things, also be in touch. We created one email address for that, very simple, ai@tmssoftware.com. Join us in this exciting new way of dealing or working with AI in combination with Delphi apps, Delphi IDE. We are excited. We look forward to share work on IDs and see where this can lead us, where this can make us an even more unparalleled productive Delphi developer in the near future. Be in touch and also subscribe on this video series here to be informed by upcoming new videos about this and other topics. Thank you.